Yo, what's up, guys? Trouble Links here. Welcome back. Check out my fittings really quick here, so you can see. Got some Mark V medium missiles. Got some Mark V stasis web. Got a small NOS. Got a Mark III drone. Got Mark V across the bottom here too. This one's a missile guidance computer, gives me extra range. Go ahead and check out some skills really quick. Just basics in here. I'm gonna start upgrading those as well soon, but I just haven't gotten there yet. I have been working on missiles a bit, so that's that. The reason I come to you today is because I have something here in my inventory, in my item hanger. Personal item hanger. I have this here mission shit, story mission shit. So this on the market, you know, people are selling them for 11, 12 million, trying to buy them for 10. These are the end of the storyline arcs in encounters. Except you'll get one of these. Now these are ridiculously hard. Okay. Expect like waves of 20 plus rats. And expect at least, you know, 5 elites in a wave. As a general rule. I'm going to go ahead and accept one of these. Mission accepted. See if I can get any tips. Nope. Alright, so we're going to go into encounters now, and you'll see that I have this special mission here. This mission lasts for 10 days. This one's only worth 15 million ISK. So looks like it's only one battle here this time. So that's not too bad. The one I did the other day was 2 battles. It took me quite a while. There was a lot of lag in the middle. A lot of bugs from the new update. But we did manage to finish it. We're going to go ahead and jump to this. I'm going to skip over all of the warping stuff. We'll get back to you when we get there. Alright, here we go. So the mission has dropped me here. In Mara. Made a stop along the way just to fill in some storyline details. And then I did not allow it to warp me into the anomaly. Because that's just suicide. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to look at structures. Here in my scanner. And I'm going to see that there are actually no structures here. So what I did was I went into my region map, I set my filter to structures, and I found the closest station, and I went ahead and bookmarked it for my autopilot. I'm still not targeting anything. Nothing is within range. I'm gonna slow down a little more. If we can draw out this manticore, that would be cool. I'm not actually seeing any elites on this. This looks like this might actually be fairly easy to accomplish. It's only worth 15 million. The one I did the other day was 25 million. Looks like this manticore is coming out now. Quorum is holding about 10 behind, but you can see now they're starting to string out. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to look at Passari, and I'm going to look at asteroid belt, because what I want to do now is try and spread the even further. So if I have to warp out, I want to warp out that's aligned to this in a direction that's going to pull things sideways. If I go to the opposite side, I'm just going to fold them back on themselves, and it's not really going to have the same effect. Wish this manticore would hurry up a little bit. Also want to keep an eye on that griffin. He's right here. But that manticore should be in range now. And then we'll speed up again. Just want to get him inside of my 41 kilometer range. Now while I'm doing this, we're going to look here and see we're 165 kilometers now from center. Tagging him now. He's running a shield extent or a shield booster, which is not a huge deal, but it does mean that that first salvo didn't really do what I wanted it to. That's okay. I'm gonna give it that reduced blast radius. Increased velocity, and we're going to speed up a little bit now. Remember, this is all Mark 5 fittings. The drone is only Mark 3. The NOS is only small. Nothing special, nothing named. Showing you the power of the mighty Caracal trainer. Slow back down again. Now, at this point, I feel like they've spread out pretty well. Don't have too many major concerns right now. I'm gonna slow right down. We got some extra DPS, we've got some extra range. Let's check on that right now. Oh, I guess not extra range. Maybe that's higher level. But what are we at now for DPS? Ooh, my Caracal moved up pretty quick. Let's go ahead and check on our ship status again here. Got a Caracal, we've got a Griffin, we've got a Griffin. I'm actually kind of concerned about this Ewar. Griffin. Ewar is electronics warfare. I'm just not going to let him get too close here. But we should maybe we can approach this guy here. Is that gonna push us closer though? I don't want to get closer yet. Let's approach this one. Not quite ready to drop in closer yet. But I just don't want to get too far here. And I'm gonna lock. Oh, these are both Ewar. Okay. I'm gonna lock both these Griffins. I do want to take them out. Ewar, the concept of Ewar scares me. And if it wasn't for the potential DPS of this Caracal, which is moving in fairly quickly now, I would focus on those Griffins. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and finish this off here. I may pause throughout it with little tips as I go along. I'm trying to remember everything that I've learned so far because I want to try and bring you as much information as I can, and I know these things get a little lengthy, but it's because, you know, it's a lot to cover, and really it's situational. And so I could tell you something in it, but if you don't see the situation, how it works, then it doesn't really, you know, it doesn't really apply in your mind. So I want to bring you the situation so that I could tell you, you know, how to act within it, or, you know, a possible way to act within it, because these are not definitive. These are just what I have learned so far. I've only been playing, like most of us, for about a month now. So there's still a lot to learn. These are still just basics, really, in terms of the overall gameplay. It's just surviving and, you know, making some fast discs so that you can move on and do other things. But also, I wanted to show off this Caracal trainer because, you know, as we know, trainers are insured. And if you can learn to make a lot of money off of your trainer, then you can set yourself ahead in the game. I did not learn this right away, and so I'm behind the eight ball, so to speak. I am out of tickets, and I'm just now starting to earn fast isk. So it is definitely more high stakes, but you know, it is also part of the learning curve. That's the whole point of the insurance, is eventually it runs out, and eventually you're just gonna have to suck it up and be extra careful when you start the battles, because you know, you're not always gonna have that backup plan of, oh, I'll just repair it. No, eventually you're just gonna run out. And to be honest, it cost me less to buy this Caracal trainer than it did to repair it by a good half million.
We'll be right back. Take your time, it's alright. Everything will work out fine. I'm seeing colors bleed. They're like running with me. I'm seeing moments driving circles. Take your time, it's alright. Everything will work out fine.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Behold the power of the mighty Caracal train. So we're going to go ahead and finish picking these loots here really quick. Finish off the storyline, look at our paycheck. We'll see what's in our special crate. And then we'll go home. We've got some mining to do for an upcoming build for corporations, so playtime is over. I'll show you the end of the storyline, just so you can see what it is. But that's it for the battles. Thanks for tuning in, thanks for showing up. This is Tribal Links. We're signing off.
Drive active.